Well, thank you, Leslie, and good afternoon, sisters, brothers, comrades and friends. What a fantastic turnout. 150,000 member people out on the streets today. I want to thank all of you for making the effort to be here to march so that we can demand in our ongoing campaign to the political elite fairness for workers. We're marching against austerity. We're marching for a decent pay rise. And we're marching for social justice. And you should be very proud of the role that you play in that. And austerity, of course, which takes from those that have little and gives to the already rich. And austerity, which humiliates the poor, the disabled, the vulnerable, but protects the city elite. Comrades, today I'm proud to stand with hundreds of thousands of NHS workers and civil servants who took strike action this week. They are decent people doing a decent job, and they demand a decent wage. This government, of course, wants to blame ordinary workers for the collapse that was caused by corporate greed and casino capitalism. And we here today march for those workers and for the millions who are facing the largest cuts in their living standard in peacetime Britain. But we need to do more than just march. We need more than anger. We need to mobilise and we need to organise. For over 4.5 years, the coalition government has set about dismantling and destroying all of the gains that we've made since 1945. The Tory mission is to dismantle the health service and to slice by slice serve it on a platter to their mates in private health companies. They seek to destroy the welfare state, characterising anybody on benefits in their time of need as a scrounger, and devastating local authority to the point where the care of our elderly is now defined by spreadsheet economics, sliced into 10-minute blocks, irrespective of people's needs. So imagine, colleagues, another 5 years of this Tory government, £40 billion worth of cuts. It would eradicate every socially progressive gain we have made in the last 70 years. So Britain needs more than a pay rise. It needs a government that fights for working people, just as the Tories fight for the rich. We know here, colleagues, that there is an alternative to Tory misery. It's about building homes, bringing banks under real public control, freezing energy prices, renationalising the rail, and a boost to the minimum wage of £8 an hour now. And you know when they say to us, well, where's the money come from? Well, we say to the rich and to the corporate giants, pay your taxes, you greedy bastards. Colleagues, it needs strong trade unions. Strong trade unions is what is needed. It needs a mass movement for social justice in our towns, in our villages, in our workplaces. And it needs a Labour Party that offers a clear socialist alternative at the next election. So I say this to Labour. I say this to Labour. Stop being scared of your own shadow. Don't shrink. Don't shrink what you offer to the British people. The time for timid is past. Be brave. Be inspired by this march today. Believe that people power and working class movements can change our country for the better. Comrades, the achievements of our forefathers and mothers are in our hands. Hold on tight to our heritage. Don't loosen your grip. Keep the faith, keep fighting, and victory will be ours.